They're here.
The following is a six-man tag team match. And at a combined weight of 513 pounds, Clown Dio Case, Natsoli, and the Celtic Warrior Sheamus, the Bar.
And guys, this looks to be a match with major implications here in WWE. Could change the entire landscape here. The Scottish Warrior, Drew McIntyre, has arrived, and a fight is about to start.
We have learned that wherever McIntyre goes, brutality follows.
Right now, it is McIntyre who is leading the WWE Universe into battle.
WWE Intercontinental Champion, the Scottish Warrior, Drew McIntyre.
McIntyre laser focused. His first time in WWE, in his words, was a failure.
Yeah, but Drew McIntyre left WWE. He proved himself and then returned to become a champion and a main event level talent here in WWE. The look of confidence on the face of Drew McIntyre says it all. He's about to do what he loves to do most, and that's get in a fight.
At a combined weight of 498 pounds, the Triple Crown Worldwide Tag Team Champions.
Each of these competitors has incredible singles potential, but as a group, they may just be unstoppable. Two very different but equally intimidating teams going head-to-head here.
I'm not sure who I'd pick as the early favorite coming into this. Either team could get the job done.
I think that's exactly why the WWE Universe is so excited to see this one play out.
Shoulders down for the count. Two!
He won't allow himself to be embarrassed this early on.
Enziguri connects. Entering a six-man tag match has challenges unique to this type of match, doesn't it, Corey?
Absolutely, Cole. In a six-man tag match, the pace can get absolutely frantic. Not only does the ref have to keep track of the legal man, but the opponents do too. It's very easy to lose track, and once you do, you can lose the match.
Tag made.
Big clothesline. He's taking some good hits.
Oof.
Great cardio makes all the difference, helping you stay alive deep into the match.
He's taking a moment to feel the crowd, but he better focus on the opposition.
He's got it.
Oh, let's get it on.
Heel hook. Look at this. Oh, that's so painful.
It's hard to watch, too.
Certainly has to be piecing together a new game plan now.
The adrenaline is pumping, and the WWE Universe is on his side.
With precision.
This is going to get ugly.
McIntyre's in dire straits.
And out of the ring he goes.
Rolling next snap.
McIntyre is getting dismantled.
Rarely do we see Drew get disassembled like this.
Oh, McIntyre holding him at bay. This is a show of confidence or a wasted opportunity to attack your opponent.
That dodge can buy Drew time.
Oh my God, what a fall!
Right to the jaw.
And McIntyre getting clobbered there.
They stuck it out through this match, but it wouldn't hurt to go for the tag soon here.
Yes, tag!
Kick right on point.
Got their opponent.
opponent all tied up. This is unique offense and painful as well.
Pull right in the button.
Takedown. He gets tagged in.
Going right after the neck.
Neck breaker.
Ooh, man.
Ooh.
Ooh. Able to avoid any harm there.
There's the switch. Drew McIntyre's in.
Looking for the victory.
McIntyre gets away from that. This match grinding him down a lot.
Floor of a Russian leg sweep.
We are seeing a next-level performance from these competitors tonight.
They've shown a lot of resiliency. You have to give them that.
Good God, what a knee. He has been here before, and he knows what he needs to do.
Ooh, harsh kick. Caught by the chin. Hits the head scissors.
Match continues.
These guys feel no love for each other. Here's another look.
Make way for the double champ.
The following champion versus champion contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the All-Star Eastern Wrestling World and International Championships. Introducing the champion from Long Island, New York, weighing in at 226 pounds, he is the All-Star Eastern Wrestling World Champion, MJF.
Imagine all the hard work, the training, and the perseverance it takes to win a title in WWE. Now double it, and you can see the magnitude of this man's accomplishment.
In WWE, the only thing more difficult than becoming champion is staying champion. And his journey was twice as hard, but the work from here is double too.
But if anyone is up to the challenge, it's this guy. The most lethal superstar in the history of WWE, the Apex Predator.
And introducing the champion from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 250 pounds, the Viper, Randy Orton!
Think of all the legendary factions that Randy Orton has been a part of. All steps in his career greatness.
He learned from the best, but at a very early age, Randy proved he can go it alone.
Yeah, we learned very quickly that Randy Orton was the student. He is able to surpass the masters.
In the process, Randy Orton has become a master in his own right.
Orton looks like he's ready to stalk his prey. And Randy Orton's methodical pursuit of self-serving goals is synonymous with his personality.
A superstar who always gets what he wants. My sources tell me that Randy Orton wants you to go home, Saxton.
Well, Randy's ready to consume more prey here tonight. You might want to take Corey's advice, Saxman. A double title match here. Major implications.
This title defense begins, and it really is lonely at the top, wouldn't you say?
Once you're at the pinnacle, Saxton, you don't care about friends. You have one solitary goal, and that is to defend your title at any cost. Isolating the arm. Seated drop kick.
To be mindful of the referee's count here. Whoa. Driven into the barricade.
Two.
Oh, man, meeting the barricade.
Oh, he slammed his face right into the barricade. Hooked him up. High angle, belly to back suplex.
The hardest thing to account for against Randy Orton is his experience. How do you possibly counter a guy with two decades of in-ring action under his belt?
Against an expert like Orton, it's all about watching him closely. You need to avoid his big moves and chip away at him. Awareness is going to be absolutely key.
Staring back to his feet, but he might not know where he is.
He needs on the top. Oh, the way to the outside. That's gravity taking a break before coming down like thunder. Scouting.
Gets put into the barricade.
Oh, he slammed his face.
Probably not going to wait for a couple hundred years, Byron. You know why?
Because the Billy Goat's curse is in effect.
Oh, I can't stand this move.
Oh, what a play escape.
Off the barricade. Russian leg sweep
right into the barricade.
Six.
Comes back into the ring. And we are down to the proverbial wire here, guys.
Match hanging in the balance. Time to get back in the ring.
Ball away slam.
Probably not going to wait for a couple hundred years, Byron. You know why?
Because the Billy Goat's curse is in effect.
Can't stand this move.
Hot. Agonizing roll. Gonna find a way out, and they do.
Will it be?
And the count stopped short of two.
I can't believe it. He just won't go away.
Strapped.
Suplex spine crushing. kick to the gut.
Another damaging kick. Oh, and a clothesline to follow. Boom.
Orton measuring.
Back on Orton.
Setting it up. Big brain buster.
Five.
Thrown back in under the ropes.
Clothesline.
Oh, that'll leave a mark.
Orton playing mind games with the enemy. He returns to the ring. Placed in the corner now.
Clothesline in the corner.
He's going to the pin. This could be it.
Into the pin window.
I am in shock. What's it going to take to keep this guy down?
Oh, back elbow.
Just mounted with punches.
And now, oh, a nasty stop to finish it off. Electric crowd.
Timing with that reversal.
Perfect. Well, I'm not going to wait for a couple hundred years, Byron. You know why?
Because the Billy Goat's curse is in effect.
Oh, I can't stand this move.
Hi, Colt. What a unique submission maneuver here. And look at the pain as a
ball. What a great escape.
Right in the head. Utilizing the top rope to inflict more punishment. Across the top rope. I can't believe he's out here.
You and me both.
This guy should be ashamed of himself.
Just cranking the head. That's gonna hurt. Cranking the head.
Stomping away.
Over. Cover here. And he fights it off.
Obviously still has some fight left.
The Viper.
And here's another look at what made that match so special.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your and the Viper, Randy.
Turn of events. One round ends and another begins.
Safe to say, things did not go to plan here tonight.
Yeah, no one ever plans on losing their title. Coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, is our Tag Team Championship match.
And this is the one I've been waiting for all day, Cole. What these teams can do inside that ring never ceases to amaze me.
The WWE Universe on their feet. Guys, the ECW World Tag Team Championship is on the line. To me, that means we should expect a brawl.
I totally agree, Cole, but not just a brawl. Expect a knockdown, drag-out bedlam.
The following contest is a tag team match set for one fall, and is for the ECW World Tag Team Championship. Introducing the challengers at a combined weight of 493 pounds, Jimmy and Jay.
I'm loving this matchup. The best teams around facing off for the titles.
The bell is rung and anything goes in this no disqualification match.
This is just going to be a brawl that can turn real ugly real quick.
No rules to obey means no limit on how nasty this one can get. And I love it.
What grace. Float over the DDT. Open clothesline. What agility.
Right on point.
Suplex. Here it comes.
Nicely done.
Superstar who's smarter, faster, and better. Using the rules to your advantage doesn't make you the villain here.
Big impact to the back of the neck.
Shot punch. Clothesline.
Well, that'll leave a mark.
Thrown back in under the ropes. Tag made. Tag made. What grace. Float over.
DDT.
Into a sleeper hold. Oh, and a neck breaker. Suplex. The challenger's looking shaken. Absolutely no telling what's underneath the ring tonight.
He's thinking a steel chair is just what he needs to wreak some havoc here.
Somehow Jay's gotta turn the momentum around.
These are dangerous attacks on their own, but now the damage is exponentially multiplied.
Belly to belly! Vicious. Raw drop kick.
Letting his opponent know he can take on the world right now.
And Jason McCurry.
Jay Uso tags in.
Sledgehammer connects. That'll scare the ring. One wicked attack after another. And you can tell there are cruel intentions in mind right now.
And you never want to count a competitor out, but there seems to be no signs of defense right now.
And it is clear the mission now is to destroy and incapacitate. And things are just going from bad to worse.
But champ teetering on the edge. There is no way this can go on for much longer. Critical time in this matchup.
This is a time to dig deep.
And he gets delivered back into the ring.
Nasty right hand. That's a good crashing to the floor.
Jimmy Dodge.
Twist of fate,
a championship level move.
Maybe not.
some of the action.
The following contest is a Falls Count Anywhere match and is for the World's Heavyweight Championship.
Ladies and gentlemen, as a reminder, the championship is on the line here tonight.
And in looking at the opposition, I can say that the champion will have quite the hill to climb in this one.
He's told anyone who will listen that he always has been the uncrowned champion of this division. Now he can make it a reality.
Make way for the double champ.
Imagine all the hard work, the training, and the perseverance it takes to win a title in WWE. Now double it, and you can see the magnitude of this man's accomplishment.
In WWE, the only thing more difficult than becoming champion is staying champion. And his journey was twice as hard, but the work from here is double too.
But if anyone is up to the challenge, it's this guy.
Introducing the challenger from Huntington Beach, California, weighing in at 282 pounds, the Samoan Joe. And his opponent from Wichita Falls, Texas, weighing in at 340 pounds, he is the world's heavyweight champion, Keith Lee.
The champion has no intention on tonight being their final night with the title.
This is arguably the biggest challenge the champ has faced yet.
You can feel it.
Absolutely. We can easily see the title change hands with
it. Or we can see a champion do whatever it takes to prevent such a thing from happening, gentlemen.
And a right hand to the jaw. My goodness.
He's begging him to get up so he can put him back down.
From the top. What's coming here? Submission move being applied.
Oh, targeting the shoulder with the claw.
He's got it.
Escape and a takedown.
And a slap to the gut, too.
Oh, just turned that around.
Oh, that hurt.
Out of the floor.
That's playing fast and loose with your own body.
That is weaponizing your body. That's what that was.
Go behind.
Jordan! Nine!
Corey, what are the perils of this match that superstars must be concerned with?
Now, this is the type of setting where you must beware of outside interference, because when it's no disqualification, it's not considered interference. It's legal.
The match can change in an instant when another individual who is not officially part of the match makes their presence felt.
That's when a competitor needs to utilize the anything-goes stipulation to their benefit and eliminate the mismatch.
Oh, my God, what a forearm!
Right to the jaw.
Everyone get out of the way. These two are abandoning all restraints.
Vicious right forearm.
Look at this, no quit whatsoever, raining down elbows and escaping the bear hug.
From the top!
Dying two count there.
He's nowhere near ready to stop fighting yet.
Oh man, meeting the barricade.
In his approach.
Holy, meet the barricade.
Oh, right to the back.
And he barely evades.
Running power slam.
Bang.
Oh, he knew what was coming.
An inverted atomic drop.
Very nice.
Ooh, again.
And gets tossed back into the mat.
Taking this outside.
This could be good.
Gonna carry the wrong bad spot to be in.
Many a match is turned on that kind of contact with the apron. This could be a key moment.
And here we go.
My goodness.
I think the champ's got it.
Two count.
Still in this. The title hangs in the balance.
Just barely able to kick out. I thought the champ had it in the bag.
This is how much the championship means. You can see the sweat drip out of the challengers every pull.
And the heaviest hitter in the arsenal was not enough.
Your opponent.
Oh, man.
there's something beneath the ring.
The steel chair never as innocent as it looks.
Uh-oh. Up across the shoulder.
Knee-breaker.
Forget walking after that one.
See the attention being put on the torso area.
Oh, an inverted atomic drop.
Very nice.
Ooh, again.
Pinning down their opponent's arm.
Dropping the knee for more punishment.
Thrown back into the ring.
And he has free reign to the outside with no countouts to worry about.
Set up for a second time.
Oh, my goodness. Looks like the champ is going to retain.
These guys feel no love for each other. Here's another look.
Here is your winner, and still World's Heavyweight Champion, Keith Lee.
A taxing victory here.
Getting it done the hard way.
I don't care if it's your fifth victory or your 5,000th. As he's showing right now, nothing matters.